Welcome to lecture 1-2. We were discussing methods and principles for locating and supporting workpiece in fixtures and jigs. In the previous segments, we discussed the concept of restricting degrees of freedom. In this segment, we will discuss some principles or rules for locating and supporting workpiece in fixtures and jigs. The first principle that we will discuss is regarding positioning the locators. Whenever possible, the locator should contact the workpiece on machine surface for accurate placement of part in the tool. So this ensures repeatability of fixture or jig. So before placing the workpiece in jig or fixture, if it has a machine surface or flat surface, that must be used for locating. Because repeatability is one of the major benefits that we achieve while using fixtures and jigs. It is the feature of the tool that allows different parts to be machined consistently within their required tolerances. Accurate location is an important element in the repeatability of any tool. And this repeatability ultimately helps us to achieve interchangeability of the parts that are made. So in the case of 3-to-1 principle, we saw that the three pins at the bottom were contacting the workpiece on a machined surface. The second important point regarding positioning the locators is that locators should be placed as far apart as possible. It permits the use of fewer locators and ensures complete contact over the locating surface. And locators should be placed so that to avoid the interference of chips. So the distance and position of the locators should be such that chips do not accumulate and they do not jam the overall system, the jig fixture and the workpiece and the drill bit that we are using. If this is not possible, then locator should be relieved. We will discuss how we can relieve a locator once we discuss the design and types of different pins in one of the following segments. And one example to relieve the locators is to use diamond pins. So in the 3-to-1 principle, we saw cylindrical pins, but we can use diamond pins that do not contact the workpiece throughout their periphery, but on certain points. So there are other options, other possibilities of relieving the locators as well that we will discuss in one of the following segments. And finally, a minimum of 3 points must be used to locate a horizontal flat surface. Because if you are using 2 points, the workpiece will not be stable. So minimum 3 points are required because 3 points make a plane on which the workpiece can rest. And if you are using 4 points and you are locating the workpiece through pins, the fourth pin should be adjustable to avoid any variations in the flatness of the surface. So this is the figure of 3-to-1 principle. The pins should contact the workpiece on a machined surface. The three pins or other pins should contact the workpiece on a flat surface. Pins should be as far apart as possible, or it could be other locators as well, other than pins. So they should be as far apart as possible. Minimum 3 pins are required to locate through a horizontal or flat surface. So these are 3 bottom pins in the 3-to-1 principle. And here the concept of relieving the locator is not shown. We will discuss that in one of the following segments. And the distance between the locator should not be low, should not be less as shown here, because workpiece will not be properly supported. It can move or it can vibrate during machining. So the operation cannot be performed properly. So the distance should be increased like this. Another principle is related to the tolerance. As a general rule, the tool tolerance should be between 20 and 50% of the part tolerance. So the workpiece being machined has certain tolerance, and the jig or fixture that will be used is also to be manufactured using some process. The tolerance on jig or fixture should be between 20 and 50% of the part tolerance. So of course it should be less than the part tolerance. And this rule applies almost everywhere in the design of tooling. And we will see the application of this rule in the design of limit gauges as well. Secondly, the locators must be made to suit the MMC of the area to be located. Now, we have already discussed in one of the previous segments what is meant by MMC. Let's take just a couple of examples to further clarify it. So we saw this example in the previous segment as well. So this is the workpiece, and on the right side is our fixture. So this workpiece shown on the left side is to be located through this hole. So this is the locating surface. And the locating device is this pin in the body of the fixture. Now the question is, what should be the diameter of this pin? So this diameter of the pin should be according to the MMC of this hole. So whatever is the size of this hole, so its upper limit will be 2.01, lower limit will be 1.99. And we know that in the case of a hole, the lower limit is the MMC. So this pin should be made according to the MMC, that is the smaller diameter of this hole, that is 1.99. Because if the pin is made larger, then the smaller holes towards the lower limit will not fit into this pin, right? For example, if this pin were made according to the upper limit equal to the size of 2.01, then the holes that were of 1.99 or 2.00 diameter will not fit. So basic purpose of locating the workpiece will fail. So it could be other way around as well. If we had an outer feature, a solid feature through which we had to place the part or locate the part in the fixture or jig, then that would have been made according to MMC. For example, this is the diameter of the part, external diameter of the part. So what should be this diameter of the hole in the body of the jig or fixture? This should be according to the larger diameter of the part or MMC of the part, so that the part can easily fit. But if this hole in the jig or fixture were made smaller and the workpiece size was made to the upper limit, then this workpiece won't fit into this hole. So this point must always be kept in mind. The third principle is the principle of foolproofing. It's a means by which the tool designer ensures that the part will fit into the tool only in its correct position. So this workpiece should be in this orientation when it is to be placed in the jig or fixture. It should not be in this orientation. So this is the foolproofing pin that we are using. So if by mistake, worker position the workpiece in this orientation, so this pin will interfere and the worker will come to know that he or she is loading the workpiece incorrectly. Similarly, this part should be this orientation. This has already a smaller hole and a larger hole. So larger hole should be toward the right side and the smaller hole should be toward the left side. But if by mistake the workpiece is positioned in the opposite direction, then this larger pin, that is the foolproofing pin, will interfere here and we will come to know that the workpiece is positioned in the wrong orientation. Let's take another example. So this workpiece should be in the orientation shown. But if by mistake, if it is placed in the opposite direction, I mean, if this side is by mistake placed on the opposite end in this orientation, then this foolproofing pin will interfere this part because this thickness is less here, this thickness is larger. So if this surface is by mistake positioned in opposite direction, then these pins will interfere because this end will not fit between these two pins. So we will come to know that the part is being positioned in the wrong direction. So in the terminology of lean, this is called ओकायोके और मिस्टेक प्रूफिंग. The final principle is to avoid duplicate locators. The use of duplicate locator should always be avoided. So for example, this is the body of the jig or fixture, and this is the workpiece. So if we are locating it through this surface, then we should not locate it through this surface, because this is the same surface in the same plane. And again, consider the concept of tolerance. Because if the workpiece is made according, let's assume that this hole in the body of the jig or fixture is according to the upper limit of the part. Now, if the part is made according to the upper limit, it will fit as is shown in the figure. But if it is made according to the lower limit, this bottom surface of the part will not contact the bottom surface in the body of the jig. So it will reach somewhere over here, and it will not contact the workpiece. And if the hole in the jig or body is made according to the lower limit, then this surface sometimes will not contact the body of the jig or fissure. So in simple words, the part will not fit in the jig or fissure properly. So either use this surface as a locating, or use this surface as a locating surface. Both surfaces will either will not let you fit the part in the jig or fixture, or it will not be used for location. Here is another example. So if you are using hole for location, you are locating the part through hole using pins, then these outer pins should be avoided, because either the part will not fit, or this pin or this hole will create some problems. So locating the part from both the outside and the holes can create some problems. So you have to decide whether the part is to be located from the holes or edges, but not both. Both should not be used. And the same problem is here. So if you are using these two locators, then these should not be used. And if you are using hole for location, then pins should not be used. And let's take the same example that we saw in the 3-to-1 principle example. So if you are using another pin in this side, so that will be duplicate locator. Because if it is made according to the lower limit, then it will not contact the workpiece. And if it is made according to the upper limit, the part may not fit into the jig or fixture. So duplicate locators should always be avoided. Thank you very much.